Good evening, students. Yesterday we had learnt about the circular flow of income between two sector of an economy, or you can say the circular flow of income in a simple economy. In that circular flow, we had understood that how the factor services and goods and services are exchanged between two sectors, or factor payment or consumption expenditures exchanged between two sectors. If you remember, you can see here in this diagram that I told you that the blue line shows real flow and the dashed black line shows money flow. Okay, real flow, you can see here the blue line, it shows the flow of factor services between household to business sector and the flow of goods and services between business and household sector, right? Okay, and the second is money flow. Money flow shows, you can see here, for their factor services, business sector provides factor payment to the household sector, and out of that factor income which household earns, okay, it spends that income for buying goods and services. It means it provide consumption expenditure to the business sector. Okay, so today after looking at this diagram, okay, we have understood two different types of flows, real flow and money flow. Right, you can see here that real flow involve only the flow of physical things like factor services, household provide its physical efforts, and business sector provides goods and services. Right, there is no monetary flow in it. Okay, and this outer loop with black dashed lines, it shows that how for their factor services, business sector provides factor payment to the household. It means money is exchanged, and household spends money on the payment, on the purchase of goods and services. It means it provide again money to the business sector. So this dashed line, which we call money flow, it is showing the transfer of money between the two sectors, right? So after looking this diagram and on the basis of our study, we are in a position to understand the difference between real flow and money flow, which is our today's topic. Okay, so the real flow, its meaning is, we have done it earlier, the flow of goods and services and factor services. Goods and services, firms produce goods and services and it provide to the household sector, and household provides factor services to the business sector. So that's why we have written the flow of goods and services and factor services across different sectors of an economy. Now you should know why we have written different sectors where we have taken only two sectors, because it can, this flow can be between three sectors also, four sectors also. Are you understanding my point? Okay, so commonly we have written between different sectors, whereas money flow, it is the flow of money. What kind of flow of money? Factor payment, consumption expenditure. Okay, now nature of transaction. Nature of transaction means which things are exchanged. You know, in real flow, what is exchange? Physical output. Physical output in what sense? Factor services by household to the business and goods and services from business to household, right? And it is the flow of monetary transaction among the sectors. Flow of monetary transaction means money flow shows the flow of money. In what form? Factor payment from business to households and consumption expenditure from household to business. Third is nature of flow. Nature of flow, its other name is also known as physical flow. Why? Because it involves the flow of goods and services and factor services, right? And it is also known as nominal flow. Nominal flow means, why it is called nominal flow? Because it involves the exchange of money between different sectors. Thank you.